Qiu in the black, Akimoto in the white. High kick from Akimoto, the more he gets, he then goes downstairs. Kyokushin has the hardest kicks of any form of karate. Whipping, looping, punch off the lead hand there from Akimoto.
Yeah, pay attention to that right leg of Akimoto. He plans to use it heavy, and he plans to use it often.
Akimoto edging forward. Good evasion and a counter there from Qiu Jianliang.
See, there's that lean back that I spoke about on the walk. QJL has got really good eyes, very good reaction times, but he's gonna have to deal with the speed of Akimoto.
I like this game plan of Akimoto so far, going to the rear leg of Qiu. Again goes to the back leg. And he's got such power and good trajectory, brings the shin down on the legs of Qiu. Right hand lead from the Chinese goes the inside thigh. Counter there from Qiu.
I like how Akimoto is mixing in the targets, right? He's not just throwing one or two. He's throwing multiple shots. He's going to the legs, the head, and the body with all these shots. You can see Qiu is evading one shot, but he's not evading the second one or the third one.
These are walloping leg kicks from Akimoto. They're coming with power, they're coming with speed, and they are coming with precision. I don't know if Qiu Jianliang quite expected this. High kick from the Chinese athlete.
Yeah, the no speed advantage is definitely going to Akimoto right now, trying to defend that number three spot next to his name.
Oh, the inside leg kick hits that femoral artery. Good high check there from Akimoto. Knee to the midsection of Qiu. And referee Olivier Cox breaks it. 1 minute remains, first round of three. Great opening round for Akimoto. And Qiu picks him up with a front kick.
Good timing on that push kick from Qiu.
Another Mawashi Geri downstairs from Akimoto. The power salvos are from the Japanese so far. Catch and counter not permitted under kickboxing rules though.
He's throwing that leg kick almost like Dutch style. How he's turning his hip over and turning into that leg kick with those hooks. I like how he's setting up that leg kick with those hooks too.
No holding, okay?
Qiu hasn't settled yet. And it's not to do with nerves, it's to do with the work rate and the power coming from Akimoto. Oh, look at that! A high Mawashi Geri, the headache maker.
Yeah, that round kick. He comes with zero setup. That's He's got such dexterity in that hip where he can just fire that from such a variety of positions.
I have never seen Akimoto load up his shots in the first round like this. That was insane. Look at the way, no doubt about it. Put it in the record books, 10-9, Hiroki Akimoto.
I don't think a lot of people expected that call right there from Cervello.
Oh, come on, you're saying that should not be a 10-9
round? I'm just saying the hype behind QJL has been so intense leading into this bout that to say that Michael Cervello just gave the first round with moves like that, look at that high kick. Akimoto is putting together multi-shot combinations with great effect on QJL. Akimoto hasn't even really broken a sweat.
No holding.
Sayer Baharzada telling his brother Akimoto that he's doing an amazing job.
And he's true. He absolutely bludgeoned him with those leg kicks in the first, unofficially. But I'm sure you all agree. 10-9 opening round, Hiroki Akimoto. Let us know on social media. Use the hashtag #OneWinterWarriors. Nice sweeping low leg kick there to open up for Qiu Jianliang.
This is what QJL needs to do. He needs to start turning up, lean on that experience that he talked about, having that big fight experience, figure out a solution to everything that Akimoto's doing.
Akimoto's roundhouse kicks, known as Mawashi Geri in Kyokushin Karate, have been a treat so far. There's a roundhouse from Qiu. My Geri from Akimoto. cracks that one into the upper right rib cage. Look at the right side of the body of Qiu. It looks like it's been sunburned.
And that right roundhouse kick just comes up effortlessly as he goes headhunting. Qiu's got to be very careful to keep that guard. He says, I can do that too.
So many great Kyokushin karateka who have become champion kickboxers over the years. The likes of Slam'em Sam Greco and the late Andy Hook. Open trade round kick, spinning back fist there from Akimoto. Okay.
You good?
Just a warning.
No back of the head, okay?
Qiu accidentally striking the back of Akimoto's head while the Japanese was turned.
Looks like Chu's doing a better job of figuring out the timing of Akimoto. He's going after that support leg. Akimoto's almost telegraphing those leg kicks or those roundhouse kicks are coming, and Chu's doing this. He's trying to go after those support legs and trying to sweep them out.
You don't want to go to the well one time too many with those low sweeps, because Akimoto's going to start timing them. And when he does go those slow sweeps, he's dropping his hands, Qiu. Jab, no power though. No right hand for company. Body shots from Qiu. Akimoto closes that down. 1 minute, 5 remains. Second round of 3. First round was Akimoto's.
1 minute, Hiroki.
Some better signs here from Qiu, but he's got to start to plant his flag.
Yeah, that's what Akimoto needs to do. The head kicks were missing. A lot of lean backs coming from Qiu. He needs to go after the legs, go after the body, and start putting points back up on the board here in the final minute.
I'd like to see Akimoto go to the back leg of Qiu as he was in the first round dragon.
Yeah, he was mixing that in really well, but Chu's got good feet underneath him. He's moving really well at this point right now. You can see the leg. Look at the damage on the left leg of Qiu. Akimoto's starting to eat that up. He needs to go back to it. Impair the movement of the tank.
Double jab, good high check there from Qiu. Overhand right, ties him up, short knee on the inside. 15 seconds left. And the tank put around in the books.
Yeah, those sweeps right there are really what's scoring him. That shows dominance, that shows ring control. Really anticipating what your opponent's doing and controlling that aspect.
Break.
Two rounds down, one to go. Three judges, silver siders scoring on a 10-point must system.
Let's take a look at some of these things that Akimoto is getting hit with. It's these sweeps. Look at this timing from Tank. It's beautiful. He sees things. He's got great eyes. Highly intelligent athlete right here. Sweeping out, controlling Akimoto well. Is it one apiece?
No.
You know what, Dragon? Yeah, why not? We'll go one apiece.
QJL, Akimoto, third round. One apiece. Let's do it. So it's all about who can make the shift. Can Akimoto do what he did in the first, or will QJL continue what's happening here in the second?
Who is going to pop the clutch in the third and final round? We've got it unofficially 19 points apiece after two. Hashtag one win to Warriors. Let us know your score, folks.
Ready?
Ready? Akimoto goes the high Mawashigeti early on. Good high check there. Goes to the back leg on the inside. Overhand right from Qiu. Body shot nicely done to the abdomen. Akimoto kicks the inside leg. Then goes high, changing levels. Beautiful leg kick from Akimoto. Stuck it right on the quads.
Yeah, that's going to score for Akimoto, those leg kicks. He's got to keep going back to him. But set him up with the hands. Don't throw kicks blind.
Head kick. Qiu thought about one of his own. Akimoto, nice punch, then leg kick. That's the combination work Dragon was talking about.
Break.
Referee Olivia Cost breaks up. Olivia giving the instructions in Thai here, in which Qiu is proficient. And inside leg kick again from Akimoto.
Qiu likes that control of the head. He uses his left leg or his left hand to control the head and bury him down as he's sweeping out the leg just to give it a little bit more force.
140 remains. It's been a good round for Akimoto. He's been on the offensive and again, hook and then leg kick.
Halfway through it. Let's see what happens here. Who can take control of this? Akimoto needs to go to the body more with that body kick and also back to the leg. You can see the redness, that superficial damage that's starting to accumulate on the lead leg of Qiu.
Moves in, clinch, and knees here from Hiroki Akimoto, the Kyokushin Karate World Champion in the white. Qiu Jianliang, the Chinese superstar in the red and black. No counter there, though, from Qiu.
There's Shimawashi getting Michael. That was that one connected beautifully on the side of the head of Qiu.
You hear the corner of Akimoto saying, finish him, with under a minute to go. Nice cover. Akimoto kicks again, snaps out the jab. Qiu with a cross counter. Short knees on the inside from both men.
I want you to finish this guy. Let's go. Two.
They are calling for Akimoto to knock him out.
Great timing on those sweeps. Nice body shot there, landed. Akimoto comes right back, digging to the liver.
20 seconds now. Who will finish the stronger? High check there from Akimoto. Misses with a leg kick. Rolls over that roundhouse kick, trying to loop the shin around the back of the neck.
Sets again.
Good night.
Those sweeps are Tank's most effective shot as Akimoto is throwing that big roundhouse. Qiu is just going after that support leg. What a fight.
Fantastic contest. Mitch, they're going down to the judges. I give, and this is unofficial, I give the final round 10-9 Akimoto.
Wow, look at this. This is how that was one of the biggest shots of that round, was that high roundhouse kick where he was actually able to connect to the head and land cleanly and score. But Qiu came back with a lot of these. Those sweeps, taking out the support leg over and over. That was his money shot. He landed just as many of those sweeps as Akimoto was landing roundhouse kicks. How are they gonna score? That's the question, Michael.
All right, let's go to Dom Lau in a moment as they tabulate the scorecards here. Qiu Jianliang, fist in the air. Here's Dom.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Hiroki